Hey dude, how much money you got? Dude. Remember me? Yeah? What's wrong with your friend? He's dead.
What did I tell you? Huh?
It's cold.
Yeah, it's cold. Now your friend dead. Because you did nothing about it. What did I tell you? What did I tell you? When are you gonna get off your ass, huh? And do something. If you don't, you're gonna be next.
Three down. He can't be fucking far, so let's go regroup back at base, okay?
Thank you. Yeah, do you want to go a little bit further? Yeah, that's good. How was your weekend?
It's good. They said we're getting some meat. What's this?
Terror attacks from ISIS again today. In Berlin, Germany, a suicide bomber killed 75 people in the subway.
ISIS took responsibility for the explosion, but investigators are still trying to determine who the suspects are and if there is a refugee connection.
Germany's anti-immigration party is continuing to rally support in light of the recent attack.
Paris suffered another mass shooting, and in London, a car bomb has destroyed the entrance to Big Ben. 11 casualties counted so far.
And another hotel bombing in Islamabad has occurred with dozens of casualties. Details are still sketchy, as emergency personnel are still working the scene.
Terror threats in the U.S. have also increased. In Colorado, a suicide bombing was prevented at a busy mall when a 19-year-old man's vest failed to detonate.
He's now in custody, but three other suspects fled the scene and are still at large.
In Boston, a veteran has opened fire in a military base, killing 15 soldiers before turning the gun on himself. The president has called these terror attacks the biggest test of Western civilization after the Second World War. Airstrikes in the Middle East will continue. Sadly, these stories seem to be occurring and are an all too common occurrence. United States is dead. While giving a press conference in front of the Senate, the President, Vice President, and Secretary of Defense were shot. The nation is in shock.
You know about Team Billy, Team David, Team Flynn, happy childhood memories, proud parents, future plans. My kid will run the world. The sky is the limit. Everything is possible. But it's not. Parents give hope and trust against better knowledge. Flynn will get older and will settle for less. He will be poor, or almost poor, and we'll be proud that he makes it into the middle class. He works, he gets a family, finally cannot move, so it's over before it ever began. What Team Flynn was all about. My duty. I've just killed the most powerful person on the planet and all his corrupt partners. I've killed so many people in my life, and no one can judge me for that. I tried to show you a world for what it is, and you stood idly by. You people, you're obsessed with violence. You're focused on my body count rather than what I was telling you. So everything has remained the same. The prison and the gun laws have not changed. Lobbyists still run Washington. The rich are getting richer, the poor are getting poorer. Our health and habitat are being compromised as the corporate elite rape and pillage the earth.
The majority of the world's problems are a direct result of American policy. You think this is the greatest country on earth? It never was. You think it's a bastion of opportunity and freedom? It never was. Poor Europeans, criminals, scumbags, boarded a boat rife with disease, and they made a journey to America. They began plundering the land, raping and killing the natives, cultivating the land with slaves stolen from Africa. Today, 24% of the world see America as the greatest threat to world peace today, followed by China at 6% and Russia at 2%. Believe what you want, but the world's opinion is becoming stronger than American imperialist propaganda.
Moments ago, as the entire world mourns the loss of this political leadership, Nation Affairs Secretary Miller was sworn in as president. Stepping into the position, he stated, "The country will not rest before the murderers are found." Multiple organizations are searching for the murderers of the president. The NSA, CIA, Homeland Security, FBI, and even local police are working together and individually on various leads and suspects.
All right, hey, everyone, just stop shooting just for 2 seconds. We just want to introduce ourselves, all right?
I'm Agent Molokai, and this is Agent Jones. We've been put in charge. We're overseeing this investigation. Now we all know why we're here, to find and detain the perpetrators responsible for the assassination of the president.
And all you guys have been asked to be on this unit because you're the best at what you do. Have patience. It's going to take time, but we are going to find whoever did this.
Now let's get to work.
You got any questions that has anything to do with tech stuff? Okay. This is Agent Murray. He's the brains behind the computers, all right? You need anything, you go ask him.
I got it. White House observation footage for 24 hours leading up to the assassination.
Just the White House? Are you fucking kidding me? We need video footage from every surveillance camera within a 50-mile radius from the White House.
Everything.
I'm talking gas stations, parking lots,
traffic
buses,
lights,
trains, traffic lights, everything, anything, everything.
Okay.
If you were a cop or a soldier, you are a tool for the 0.1%. Not the general public. There is no land of the free and home of the brave. If you were a soldier, you were a puppet and nothing else. I have a son now. His name is Billy. Like most parents, I believe that my son has the ability to rule the world, create a great impact, follow my footsteps in many ways. He will be taught that anything is possible. The truth is, that's a lie. Parents are naive. They give hope to their children because it's what they had hoped for themselves. Truth is, my son will likely fall in line with the majority, just barely classified into a rapidly diminishing middle class. Let's face it, if he's not the 1%, he will be poor. Struggling to get through life, he will work into his old age, work his ass off in vain to support his family, trying to get ahead and leave something behind for his children's future, scratching and clawing to make ends meet for his entire life, and eventually his body's gonna break down. Medical insurance will be unattainable, and then his mind follows, deteriorates, and then he dies. It is what it is. Eventually everything finds its end. In the beginning, I thought it was all about me. I saw everyone around me stealing, taking for themselves without any regard for anyone else. I saw so much greed, selfishness, separation that I wanted to embody all those things in a way that no one could forget. So when people saw what I was doing, it'd be like they were looking into a mirror and they'd be forced to change. I wish that we lived in a world where there was no human or animal abuse, where we shared the planet's resources, we used the wind from the oceans, the sun from the Sahara to make energy for all of us together, where our food is distributed to everyone and no one starves and nothing is wasted, where no one is blinded anymore by religion and we listen to science and facts to really focus on the problems we all collectively face, like climate change. I wish for a world where we can all live in peace, where there's no wars, there's no weapons, there's no violence. But that can't happen. That can't happen. That won't ever happen.
The president, the vice president, the secretary of defense were killed, each one with a single shot.
Analysis of security video footage from the plaza found no indication of shooters close by, leading authorities to believe that they are dealing with trained elite snipers.
All the registered gun owners checked out. We don't have a weapon, but what we do have is a location from where the weapon was fired. It happened 1.2 miles from the White House on 7th Avenue on top of a parkade.
It's one hell of a shot.
Shot? He shot three, he hit all three. Three kills.
What if it's three shooters?
It's a possibility. I mean, this person or these persons knew what they were doing.
You need to check the other vantage points around that area.
All right. Yeah, get it. Thanks.
Make a shot like that, it's probably ex-military. There's probably only five people in the world that can make a shot like that.
Yeah.
You need to find a list of every soldier that was discharged suffering of PTSD.
Can you imagine if it's one of ours?
I don't even go there.
I'm going to cross-reference all the flight manifests with anyone that might have been involved in military or anything like that. I want to cross-reference it with anyone that could wield a gun, basically, that was coming in and out of Washington that day, because, I mean, that's not your average shooter. If it is one person. Yeah.
2 weeks after the assassination of the president, the vice president, and the secretary of defense, ISIS claims responsibility for the attack, although experts see no indication of their involvement.
Well, we gotta check every hotel, every flight manifest for any Arabs, Iraqis, Muslim jihadists.
I've been checking them,
anyone
man.
Anyone from the Middle East.
I've been checking. The only Arab is like selling kebabs on the side of the street. Why are we playing that card? Fucking souvlaki joint.
I don't.
I feel like I'm watching ants.
Put mom on the phone.
Yes, sir. Understood. I got the deputy director breathing down my neck. They want results like yesterday.
What? How long do we have? Because I'm trying to do manual facial recognitions with people right now. It's going to take us up to 20 years to be able to do that.
I think they don't want us to find whoever we're looking
That's
for.
That's bullshit. You know what I'm trying to do here right now. It doesn't work.
Guys,
it
stop,
doesn't
stop,
operate
stop.
Like
stop.
This.
Stop. Listen, enough of this archaic bullshit, okay? I'm going to turn 20 years into 2 weeks.
What do you got, Murray?
It's a new program, and it's going to help us, okay? I promise. All right, now, what this program does is it can scan every face. We can go through every single person that's entered Washington, D.C. leading up to the assassination. I mean, it's going to take some time, but pretty soon, we'll be able to identify every single person on all of these cameras. Once a person clears, they're cleared. But eventually, we're going to find our culprit. We're going to find the person who assassinated the president.
And you can bring up their IDs with it right away?
All their identification, yeah.
So we can narrow it down so that we could find people with outstanding passports, like warrants for arrest or anything like that around
yeah,
the same
if you
area,
need a
right?
specific search.
Let's do that.
All right.
When each one of these are scanned and the file comes up like that, is it backed up?
Absolutely.
I want those files printed and I want everybody going through to see if we miss anything.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'm going to get started, okay? Davidson, come with me in my office. You too.
This is good. I can't believe that we did this.
I know. It's the best thing we've ever done. The best thing.
I wanted to wake up.
You don't have, you can't put him back to sleep.
I don't think he's gonna scream.
Oh, he, that's all he's been doing.
I know how to put him to sleep. I can put him to sleep.
You're gonna hear and see a lot about me in my life. Fuck, man.
Guys, Molokai, Murray. Guys, I got something.
What is it?
It's Bill Williamson.
Who?
Bill Williamson. Fuck it. Biggest mass murderer in American history.
I thought he was dead.
So did everyone. What time is that?
This is like an hour before the shooting.
Now of our suspect.
With fucking beard on him.
Oh, he's alive? That doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, well, guess what? It's making sense. I just got him. It's him.
Well, it had to be him, right? I mean, he's in D.C. the same time the president is shot.
Haven't you seen those YouTube videos and everything that he's done?
Look, listen to this.
I want you to change the world, and don't think that this is going to happen peacefully. You can do it alone. We need to kill the rich. You get out there. You use your weapons. You rip Washington apart. You hunt down the billionaires, the bank bosses, the CEOs, the scumbags, and the liars, the governors, the lobbyists, the senators, because they're all the same. You hang them from the first tree that you can find. We need to do this together, okay? So I thank you in advance for your help.
Give me the deputy director on the phone. Sir, we have video confirmation that Bill Williamson is still alive.
Bill Williamson, the Tenderville terrorist. Where?
He was right here in D.C. the day the president was shot. Facial recognition program confirms it.
All right, I want you to call in all your support teams. Get everybody on this right away.
Absolutely.
We need to be 100% sure about this before we ring any alarm bells. Especially right now. The nation's panicked as it is.
Yes, sir.
Find him, but keep a low profile. No hints to the press.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Follow his lead.
All right.
I'm
Bill Williamson was born in the small town of Tenderville, Oregon, December 25th, 1986, to Alan and Sarah Williamson, both deceased. His mom was a social worker, dad was in the accounting firm, lived a pretty normal life, he was a mechanic. And then May 14th, 2009, a few months after his 23rd birthday, he loaded up a van with explosives, blew up police headquarters, and then he went on a killing spree. He executed 93 people that morning.
Jesus Christ.
Made off into the woods where he shot and killed his best friend, Evan Drentz. He dressed him up in the suit of armor and tried to frame him. He staged it to look like a suicide. In 2014, he resurfaced in Washington, where he blew up his car outside the television station before entering and murdering a security guard and several employees. He took the remaining survivors hostage, demanded a video be played nationwide. He also wanted a camera crew there for a live interview. Of course, we all know how that ended. And shortly after that, his father committed suicide because he couldn't handle knowing that he gave birth to them.
Now, what we needed to do is trace back the video footage from that point, second by second, see where he was that day. We need to see how he got in, how he got out, most importantly, where he went afterwards.
Molokai. Jones. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet
you. The people that are representing you are bought and paid for to keep you stupid in your small, stupid little world. How? Can there be no gun control, even though there are monthly massacres? In the USA, 11,000 people are shot every year. In the UK, it's only 300. Why? Because the UK doesn't have guns. People don't have guns, period. What I've done in the past and what I'm doing right now is the result of no gun control. There aren't even background checks to filter out.
No, I swear to God, if they just gave all of these teachers, hired some security guards, I mean, it's providing jobs for people, they give them the guns, I guarantee you all this stuff would go away.
Are you fucking kidding me? They'd be killing each other.
They wouldn't. They'd be trained professionals that are just so happen to be also teachers. But at least there would be a little bit of fear within there. Now the kids go to fucking school and they're fucking scared every day of getting shot.
My experience, you can't control human nature. People are gonna do irrational things in irrational times.
So that makes it okay?
Doesn't make it okay. It's just a fact. It's how we're built.
The USA has 5% of the world's population and 25% of its world's prisoners. People go to jail because they have 10 grams of cocaine in their pockets. Half of the prisoners are in jail for drug possession, and more than half of them are black. Why does this absurd situation not get changed?
Because they do the crime.
Because Washington gets paid to keep it going by the prison industry lobby. Why don't the rich pop stars and film stars
have you fucking been to Detroit? Do you even know? It's a black problem, man. Like, you can't just sit there and be like, oh no, it's not their fault. It is in some respects. It's not always. But you can't say the fucking black guys that are in jail aren't there for a reason. Am I racist?
Somewhat.
It's not fucking racist, it's just the truth.
Oh, look at all this police brutality. How's that justified? You see it on the internet every day.
Because everyone's fucking scared.
Yeah, but just because you're scared of someone doesn't give you the fucking right to gun somebody down unarmed in cold blood, shooting them in the back.
I agree.
It's no different than what he does.
It's very different.
He kills innocent people.
He walks down the street with
so
a
are the police.
AK. I'm sorry, what country
are you from?
Do I
agree with everything he's doing? No. But his basic message,
I can find some truth in that.
His basic message is not what he's actually physically doing. He's out there killing innocent people.
He's a psychopath.
He's killing innocent people.
Think our government's any different? Just because we do it over in the Middle East, that makes it okay?
Look, what we do over in the Middle East is for the right reasons, whether you want to believe it or not. Those guys would be bombing the fuck out of us if we weren't over there right now. And if you really wanted to know what I think, you should fucking make the whole place a parking lot and start all over again.
Can you imagine if they had all that power? Can you imagine? Like, put yourself in that situation. All of a sudden, now they have all the money, they have all the weapons and power. What are we going to be doing?
We were shaking in our fucking goddamn shoes.
Every war has been a crime. For war profiteering. That's the only purpose of it.
Yeah, well, you know what?
Call me wrong, but I've been on the winning side of most of them, and I want to stay that way.
Without the Iraq war, there'd be no ISIS. So you can blame Bush for that one.
Let's not go there.
He's following in his daddy's footsteps.
Okay, let's not go there.
Creating the war on terrorism.
Let's not go there.
War on terrorism is actually a war on our freedom.
I can't do this shit anymore.
Who the fuck do you think's running this country?
You sure as fuck ain't the president. Not anymore. How many fucking people do you think our government have killed?
I don't care about that. That's our side. This is our home. How do you guys think that way? We're fucking protecting these people.
My point is, it doesn't matter if we catch them or not. There will always be another Bill Williamson or another terrorist group like ISIS.
Our freedom is already gone. We've already been robbed of it. We just don't know it yet.
Yeah, well, ISIS didn't do this.
Bill Williamson did. So let's
go kill the fucking idiot.
He knows what he's doing.
You're fucking the most wanted man in America. Why the fuck would you walk by a camera like that? It doesn't make any sense.
Where does he sleep? I mean, we checked every hotel, motel, hostel, Airbnb.
Checked everything. Trail just went cold.
He's got the means, guys. He's got the money. If he's been gone this long, he's been hiding the whole time.
He's getting ready for us. He wants us to follow him.
You think he's baiting us?
I'm sure he is. It's a trap. He knows we're coming after him.
Agent Molokai, you're leading this investigation. So what's going on?
No comment.
Do you have any suspects? Come on, we're in the dark here. The American people deserve to know. Do you have any leads? Get any news at all, just a statement. Come on. Your silence is very unnerving. Agent Molokai, come on. You've got to tell us something.
That was Agent Molokai, leading the investigation of the death of our political leaders. Silence.
Working on something!
Hey!
What is this?
Get the utility company on the phone now.
Everything's crashed.
Murray! I mean, it could have been an electromagnetic pulse, okay? And someone would have had to do that, targeted our network.
How do we find out? How do we find out if you can do that?
I want
call someone to get someone in here for it.
Cell phone's working.
I'll go back down to the breaker room.
Look, I got nothing. I've lost fucking everything!
If someone sent an electromagnetic pulse, chances are it could have burned
everything.
Everything's white. Is everything gone?
Look, somebody did this on purpose, okay? This wasn't an accident.
Just stop talking, and whatever we need to do, get on it. We're wasting fucking time.
Tell me the most logical next step.
There's not a lot of options here, okay? But what we can do is we can reboot the whole program and start the facial recognition again.
Fucking kidding me!
That's the best I can do.
Okay.
How could you let this happen? I thought you were some sort of fucking whiz kid.
All right, leave him alone.
I'm not God, okay?
Leave him alone. It fucking wasn't him.
Well, we better get back at it. We gotta start all over again. Fuck.
You know what I was thinking about? How much you're gonna miss me when I'm gone? You're not?
Didn't I tell you there's already a...
What, another guy?
A man on a horse waiting to come get
a
me.
A man on a horse?
Yeah, he's...
What, is he from the
1800s? It's from the 1800s.
Yeah?
He's gonna ride through
the
forest.
Does he also joust?
He's going to joust his way through that forest. Pick me
he's,
up.
There's a white stallion
mm-hmm.
in the forest.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I hope he steps on one of my landmines.
I met him.
Javelin thrower.
I met him on one of those dating sites. It was really awkward.
You love the internet. You meet all your boys on the internet. Live in the moment. You're not serious, are you?
No, I'm not serious.
All right.
I wish I found him jousting.
Eventually you're gonna have to move on, though.
Don't say that. I don't want to leave you. Leave you, you know, I don't. We could just keep hiding. We could just keep running.
I can't hide. I'm not hiding. I'm not hiding. That's the whole point. I'm not hiding anymore. That's the whole point of everything that I've been doing. It is for this moment. This is it. We talked about this so many times. You're gonna stick to the plan when what we discussed. You're gonna take Billy and you're gonna go to your mom's house.
Good night, guys.
Good night.
Have a good one.
Man. We getting out of here?
Yeah, you done?
Yeah.
Alright. See you tomorrow.
Don't work too hard, eh?
Yeah.
What
was
that?
Get your ass over here.
What you got there? A little fire.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Keeps me off my edge. Ooh, it's good.
Sometimes it's the only way I can think straight. I don't mean to be a hard ass. Just, you know, just got a lot of pressure. Fucking units in my hands. This whole investigation was sliding the shit for the longest time. Then we get a lead, and they fucking wipe our feet out from right under us.
Look, don't
don't. You don't need to apologize, man. You don't apologize for anything, I get it. Molly's bugging me about going to her little recital tomorrow. Sorry, Molly, can't go. Gotta go catch terrorists.
So, why don't you wear your wedding ring, man?
To work? Well, you're not around me all the time, but...
I'm with you more than your family is.
I don't know. I just... Sometimes I feel like if I wear it, I'm bringing them into this. I don't know, this mess, and I just don't think they need to know about any of this shit. I don't tell them a thing. You're asking me about my wedding ring. Why are you wearing yours?
Wear it because it reminds me of something I once had. Keeps me grounded. Reminds me that, you know, no matter how shitty things get in this world, there's always a time in your life where you're happy. It's like I still have her with me sometimes. I know it sounds probably fucked up to you, but...
No.
This job destroyed my marriage. I was never there.
She wanted, you know, she wanted things I couldn't give her.
Probably take the puppy off here pretty soon. Not to be insensitive or anything like that, I get it, but...
People talk.
I'll make you a deal. I'll take off the ring as soon as you shave that greasy poon stash off your face.
Fuck that.
I've had this thing since I was 18, man. I'm serious. Been Tom Selleck in it for a while.
Well, I gotta drive. So... I gotta get going now.
Alrighty, get some rest.
Yeah, just I can't stop thinking about the fact that maybe we get him. Yeah. Oh well.
The CIA and Homeland Security have finally come to the conclusion that it was ISIS terrorists planted as Syrian refugees who are responsible for the deaths of our political leaders. The arrested subjects have not been identified.
The killers of the president have been found and are in custody. They entered the country as a refugee family and were ultimately turned in by their sponsor family, who grew suspicious of their
secret behavior. Hey, guys, come here quick.
The sponsors were shocked to find weapons, maps, and photos of the Senate building stashed in their guest house attic. They immediately contacted the DCPD, who searched the guest home
ISIS.
And alerted Homeland Security.
That doesn't make any sense. There's no physical evidence proving that they did this.
Are you fucking kidding me? They're taking fucking credit for everything.
Further attempts to contact the host family have been unsuccessful, and their whereabouts are unknown.
This is... Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, understood. We're done. We're gonna dissolve this unit first chance they get.
This isn't done.
Tell me about it.
We need to show what we have to them. This is ridiculous. Not let these guys fucking take advantage of all this shit.
They already sent in the intelligence report. They're fully aware of everything that we found.
Who is saying no to you?
Deputy Director.
ISIS? Is it ISIS? Did ISIS do it? Or is it little Bill Williamson from the mountaintop who tried to catch me before? What's gonna change now? Nothing. He wrapped around my little finger. I can do whatever I want. That's been proven.
We have received a statement from the Office of the President as follows. Today,
the United States of America deployed 22 nuclear warheads and 38 neutron bombs to destroy our enemies in Pakistan, Indonesia, and the Middle East. Russia and China supported the action. The resources of the Middle East will be split evenly between the U.S., Russia, China, and Western Europe. We chose to react to the ongoing chaos and terror attacks and made the decision to stop radical Islam once and for all. Effective immediately, Homeland Security is closing all mosques, and the military is rounding up the Muslim community.
America was built by scum, and it's still being run by scum. But America is the biggest military superpower in the world, the most high-tech, with geniuses in Silicon Valley making massive leaps in computer technology. It's all in an effort to neutralize and capture more poor people and enslave them and rape and pillage their communities and their indigenous resources. All of this is done with the help of religion, the great divider, the great controller, the hand of justice, whether you're a Christian, Muslim, Jewish, patriot, Scientologist, or follow any other ideology some fuckhead can dream up. If you can't disseminate what is right and wrong in context, in time and place, you are a fucking idiot. I won't say that there aren't ideologies in all religions that make sense and are useful. Any asshole can confuse philosophy, and they do. Nietzsche was misunderstood and connected to the Nazis. He also said a long time ago that on top of the mountain of wisdom is very lonely and ice cold, and if you climb it, there is no bigger gratification. All these actors and pop stars are monkeys and puppets. They brainwash the people and keep them from that mountaintop. All these comic book movies, Transformers, The Avengers, Lone Survivor, American Sniper, they're propaganda. They're perpetuated by Hollywood that in the end it just glorifies the military and the weapon industry. They do it for the money. Jennifer Aniston, Jay-Z, Tom Cruise, Michael Bay, they live in mansions on a hilltop and they have no recollection of what it's like to be a human anymore. They're a hologram that you worship.
Huh. Williamsville, Virginia. That's it, you guys, after that. He just kind of vanishes into thin air.
Completely off the grid.
What's the next stop or the next town, like, up above it?
Next train station is Fredericksburg, 110 miles from there.
You didn't see him after that, though?
No.
Well, according to the video footage, that's the last spot he got off the train.
It's a small town. There's not much there other than that train station. It's just trees and mountains.
You know it?
Yeah, I've been there before.
Should we go? Yeah, we might as well go survey the area.
It's a good start.
I want you to show this to Billy when he's old enough to understand it, okay? Take it.
I don't want to leave you.
Come here.
You hear me? Why do we have to leave? Why can't we just keep running and hide?
I can't keep hiding, you know that.
Why?
You need to go, okay? You need to take Billy. And you need to go as far away from me as possible. Like we planned, you need to do that for me, and you need to do that for Billy.
What are you gonna do for him? He needs a father. He needs you. He doesn't need a fucking DVD. He needs you.
If I can do this for me, okay? You need to go like we planned. Because they know where I am. And they're coming. safe here. So you walk out of that forest and you never saw me. And you never fucking met me. You never met me.
I wish I never met
you. Hey, don't fucking say that. Don't fucking say that.
I love you.
I love you guys more than anything. You have to go. You're gonna go see your mom, right? You're gonna tell her that you love her.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm just a lonely mother taking her son out for a hike for the first time.
Right.
I don't know where I am. And who the fuck is Bill Williamson?
Yeah. I'm looking for a man on a horse. You seen one? Okay. You're gonna be all right, okay? You're gonna be okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You're both gonna be okay. Let's get this fucker. We're gonna go in there, we're gonna take him down. Williamson's a real Boy Scout. He's taking refuge out here. It's gonna be like chasing a ghost.
Yeah, no shit.
The only shot is to scan the area, thermal imaging.
Yeah, well, I'm calling NSA. We're gonna get some drones in here, do a little aerial sweep. We'll find him.
He's out there. He's watching us right now. I can feel it.
Yeah? Hey, Bill! You wanna be a man and come out? We're right here, buddy. You wanna play?
Fucking wise ass.
Come on, let's go check the bridge.
The FBI, full-blown idiots. We've been down this road before, boys. So I know you guys are coming. Come. Bring all your boys. And I'll see you soon. I'll see you really soon.
ISIS my fucking ass! Boo! Boys! Get in here!
Boom.
Son of a bitch, is that him?
That's him. I see it the way he's moving.
Damn right it is. Get a lock on those coordinates. Maps, grids, everything within a 5-mile radius. Send these guys soon.
Let's get him.
We need at least 300 bodies searching those woods with us. SWAT, police, military, send us everyone you can.
I can't send you anyone now. You have no hard evidence, Agent. You're supposed to be dissolved by now.
You can't drop us now. We're way too close.
We have confirmed ISIS responsibility. It's in the media. This will cause a shitstorm, and we don't even know he was involved.
I know that, but we have satellite imaging confirming it's him. It's him. We have it. It's a picture, clear as day. What more do you want?
Williamson's alive, I'll give you that. But you lost his trail, and now you're coming to me on a hunch with some blurry video? That could be just some hunter.
No, you're wrong. It's him.
100%.
After we dropped the nukes, we woke up every terrorist sleeper cell hiding in our own backyard. We have our hands full with terror threats across the nation. Without something more, I have no resources to spare. You want him? Go in with what you've got.
Shit.
We're on our own.
Molokai. What kind of name is that? You know, you should listen to your colleagues a little bit more. Sometimes they might actually know a little bit more than you. You know, an asshole like you, there's a reason why you still stay single. ISIS? ISIS. Yeah, that's pretty typical. That's pretty typical nowadays. You guys are kind of underestimating your homegrown talent. One man could do it.
I'm here, I'm waiting. Seen this bridge before? This river? You know the president and what he represents, what he's trying to set up, the New World Order, and all you puppets just fall in line. Well, maybe I'll make my own New World Order. If he can do it, I can do it. You guys are just little pawns. In a game, he's not doing anything for you. You're president. That's why he has to go.
Where did that just come from?
I got it in my email. How the fuck does he know who I am? You know what? When our power went out, we must have got hacked. It's the only logical explanation.
You gotta be fucking kidding me, you sent me one too.
Jones, how's your wife Molly? And your wife's name is Sheila, isn't it? Sheila. Your daughter's name is Molly. Summerites High. No, that's a what is it? Arden Elementary.
Ah! Fuck you! Fuck you! You fucking cockfucker! No! No! Fuck you! Fuck you! Stupid fucking little girl! Fuck! Fuck!
Olga!
you're still single. But, Grandmama. Grandmama. That's what you call her? That's pretty cute.
How can he fucking know about our family?
Of course he fucking knows! Who the fuck's my phone?
This motherfucker hacked our system! He's gained full access to the whole fucking database. He fucking knows everything now.
Everything about us, everything about the investigation, all our agents.
Hey, yeah.
ISIS? ISIS. Yeah. That's pretty typical.
Everything's good.
That's pretty typical nowadays.
No, I'm just calling to make sure everything's cool.
You guys
I'm actually
going to
cook for dinner tonight. Everything's
going to
be just fine.
Talent. One man could do it.
Yeah, so you guys, you stay home, ISIS. Put a movie in and stuff like that, and I'm going to be home in a few hours, all right?
I just killed your president.
All right, I love you guys.
Your president. President is dead. The president is dead. Fuck it.
Molokai, Jones, I see you, fuck buddy investigators, you know where I am, I know where you are, I know where your family is, Jones, your wife Sheila, your little daughter Molly, I know everything about you, why don't you, bring your boys up. We'll get into an old Wild West shootout. Just you and me and your best men. If you fuck around, say goodbye to your families. A lot of followers out there. They know where you live. See you soon, boys.
Coming for you, buddy. Oh, fuck.
Ladies and gentlemen, it appears that
the FBI has a lead to the location of where Bill Williamson is hiding. We will inform you of further developments as they unfold.
Three down.
can't be fucking far, so let's go regroup back at base, okay? Let's go. Come on.
Williamson has the upper hand. We gotta make our way across this field back to the high ground.
Comb every single square inch of this. We're not leaving until we get this fucker, all right? Let's move out!
Shaft up ahead. Well, the land survey said it was up there. He's probably taking refuge up there, set up his home base.
Out here now! The rest of you, move forward! Can you hear that bell? There he is, 2 o'clock! Let's go, guys, come on!
Okay, you fucks, welcome to Camp Bill. Play safe, boys, no running. What did I tell you? Wait, we're not done yet. Don't learn your lesson! easy. Okay, where are you, Jones and Molokai?
This whole thing's a setup.
We're walking into a goddamn war zone out here.
Jesus. Look, can we send in dogs or something? Because I'm not doing this. Let's go. Stand back, guys. Okay, let's go. Move this way.
Let's get out of here.
Hey, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh! You hear that?
There you are. I see you. Look up here. Look up here.
Look. That fucker's been watching us the whole time.
Little piece of shit.
Yeah, not for long. Good shot, Jonesy. Good shot. My turn.
Fuckers.
Thanks for playing, boys. Game over.
Thank you.
a downward spiral to the end of all times, and there's no chance that we can survive. This is an absolute joke. And Evan, that's what you didn't get. That's what you didn't get. You think people are equal? They're not. They're not. I want you to change the world. Don't think it'll change peacefully or you can do it alone. You need to kill the rich. I had to kill a lot of people, and I will get killed myself to get my message to you. So I made the decision to value your interests higher than my life. I want to make you wake up and change. And I will get killed myself to get my message to you. So I made the decision to value your interests higher than my life. Your interests higher than my life. And I will get killed myself to deliver my message to you. Nietzsche once said, on top of the mountain of wisdom, it's very lonely and ice cold. But if you climb it, there's no bigger gratification. Death is coming. Death is the result, it's the consequence. So I urge you one last time, for yourself, for your family, to climb that mountaintop. You know what I'm talking about. This is my last message to you. In vain. All the best.
We interrupt your viewing with breaking news. The number one most dangerous terrorist on U.S. soil, Bill Williamson,
has been shot dead by authorities. The case of
who killed the President of the United States is now solved.
We go live to our correspondents on location.
What a horrific scene, Lori. Which terrorist was hiding all this time?
He wasn't a terrorist. Fucking idiots.
Where we are learning the FBI has found
he was just doing what needed to be done.
The very rifle that killed the president,
fuck,
vice
Bill.
President, and the Secretary of Defense. It looks like the aftermath of an all-out...
Yeah, hi, Ma. Yeah, can you come grab Billy? Take care of him for a little bit for me. Yeah, no, I'm fine. I just, I'm just tired. I'm just super tired, and I just need a break. I just need a break, okay, Ma? We're gonna be okay. there's a bunch of terrorists going around shooting people.
Who?
Look at this. They're just randomly shooting civilians. Oh my God, why are they doing this? They're killing all the rich people.
We are receiving disturbing news. From all across America, heavily armed terrorists dressed in black are shooting civilians. They are mostly targeting affluent areas, including Wall Street. There are also reports of them attacking the headquarters of the FBI, CIA, Homeland Security, the NSA, DEA, and other various military stations. There are over 1,000 shootings occurring concurrently.
This seems to be some kind of revolt against the American elite and decision makers.
This is for my son, Billy. Billy, by the time you're old enough to see and understand this video, I won't be in your life anymore. And the fact that I'm your father is going to be a distant memory for you. As much as I would like this video to be your one impression of me, I know that's not possible. You will hear and read and see a lot of me in your life, but I want you to know that my life was my own, and your life has the potential to be whatever you want it to be. You only live once, son. By the time you watch this video, you might form your own opinions of life and death and of God, but I... Hear me when I tell you this, that there is no God, okay?
There is no after. What you have is you have one life, and you need to use this life to make an impact, to make it right, because people are going to lie to you. They're going to try to keep you down.
They won't want you to succeed. They won't want you to see the truth. If you come to the conclusion that you don't want to contribute to a society where others decide what you do and what you don't do, where others use media and school systems and the law that oppresses people like you and me, people that can think for themselves, that still have free will, then you need to destroy those ideas and the people and the institutions to perpetuate them. You need to be a leader, and the masses and the rules and the laws and the ideology will change with your movement. I want to tell you that I'm sorry. I wish that I could be the father that my father was to me. That I wish I
could hold you in my arms. And I wish I could see you grow up, and I wish I could speak to you beyond this video. I wish that you could feel the love that I have for you in my heart from the moment I saw you. I hope that it protects you for your life. I love you. I'm so sorry I had to leave you.
I hope that you understand it was for the best. And I want you to take care of your mom, okay? Take care of your mom. I love you. Your father, Bill Williamson.
There are reports of heavy gunfire in the Senate and in front of the White House. Past President George Bush has been pronounced dead. as have the CEOs of General Electric and Microsoft.
We've also just learned that Mark Zuckerberg was killed by one of his own employees.
And entertainers Rihanna, Taylor Swift, and Britney Spears are also reported as deceased. It seems a group of right-wing anarchists
have revolted and have the intent to take their country back
through violence and destruction.
What? Can you
roll that back, Michael? Check it.
Did you hear what they said?
I didn't.
What's happening? Can you guys tell us what's happening outside?
What is it?
I'll just hear it.
That sounds really close. Security?
When are you gonna get off your ass, huh? Do something. Williamson changed my life. That was for him.
Thank you.